Hello world, welcome to the ninth video in my troubleshooting playlist on my channel where I'm building my own digital assistant named Shane, like Jarvis from the Iron Man movies and comics. In today's video, I'm going to show you how to quickly fix this error when you're trying to create an executable file from a Playwright Python script you created. If this helps you, please consider subscribing to my channel, liking this video, and leaving a comment. So you successfully created a Python program using Playwright in your IDE like PyCharm or maybe Visual Studio. If you want to know how, if you're struggling to use Playwright, then you can watch this video. Or you could click the card above and I show you how to use Playwright instead of Beautiful Soup. So you've tried it in PyCharm and it works and you get whatever output that you're hoping for. And now you want to create an application. So you have two options. You can use Py Installer or you can use Auto-py-to-exe. And I'm assuming you got here to this video because you're trying to use Auto-py-to-exe. But you're getting this error that we showed in the beginning. So you Googled it and you might have found some Reddit articles. You might have found a Stack Overflow. Or you might have even gotten to the documentation here that says if you want to bundle browsers with the executables, but you don't know how to implement this, right? It says you can use Bash, PowerShell, or Batch. You might have even tried PowerShell and it not work, right? So you can come to here. This is the directory that I'm in, that I have my project in. You went to PowerShell. So it opens PowerShell and then you copied this code and then you went in here like that and it doesn't work, right? You can't just copy and paste that in there. And so you're struggling to fix this error. So let me show you a quick way to do this. So first, navigate to your project where your .py is. Right, so you can, and if you're using PyCharm, you can just hover over it right here. So click into here and copy, well, don't copy and paste that. Let's go out of that. Okay, let's go back in here. And then copy and paste this right here. And then type in Gitbash. And you see this program? Open that. Okay, so now type in cd like this, that kind of backslash, and you can't press Control V, right? Because this is Gitbash. So go ahead and paste it in there and then delete the user, the C prompt like that, and then change the forward slashes to backslashes, or I'm sorry, the backslashes to forward slashes. All right, and that will take you to the directory, and you see how the directory is like this. And now go back to the documentation, and I'll leave a link in the installer, or I'll leave a link in the description. So now just copy and paste this only, just this portion right here, and paste it. And if it works, you won't get any error for this one. And then copy and paste this. I'm using Chromium. You can use other. I think WebKit is Safari. So you'll have to find in the documentation which browser you want to use. And it should match the browser in your code. So p.chromium. So I'm using Chromium in my code. All right. So again, assuming you want to use that. Then you do Playwright install Chromium. Press Enter. Mine won't do anything because I've already installed it, but yours will start to install it. It'll say 0%, 10%, 20%, and the progression bar will go to 100%. All right, and then now after you're done with that, you can skip this step, right? If you want to use Py Installer, that's fine. So you can copy and paste this, paste it, and then change this to whatever the name is of your code. So in my case, it would have been webscraper.py, right? Webscraper.py. And then I press enter, but I don't want to do that. So I'm going to use the Auto-py, so Auto-py-to-exe, right? And now we're going to go to Browse and click your .py file. All right, I'm going to click one file. So the difference between one directory and one file, one directory will create a project folder. One file will just create a file. Just one, the whole application will be in it. So it'll be rather large file size. I want it to just be window-based. So only this thing comes up right here, not a console. I don't have an icon. I'm not going to use additional files. I'm going to go to Advanced and go to Hidden Import. And in your PyCharm code, I have BS4 and Playwright. JSON you don't need because that is a standard library that it will automatically use. So BS4 and Playwright. All right, now I'm going to minimize this advanced. And I do want a custom output. So anything that you output this to, where the code will be. So I want it back in this code, this folder right here. All right, then we can close that. And now we can convert to .exe. And it will run. It's basically just a tkinter overlay of Py installer, and it creates this Py installer command for you based off of all the selections you do. But it really is kind of convenient. So in the background, it is building it for you. And it will stay on converting. Okay, so now it has completed it. It says moving project to. This is where I asked it to, and the output is complete. You can use this open output folder. And it has opened it for you, so you can close out of this command prompt. All right, so now we have an application file, right? A .exe. So a quick way to know if this worked or not is if you do not have the browser files are huge. So if your browser did not install correctly, this would be about 35 megabytes. But as you can see, mine's like 149 megabytes. That's because it has that huge browser library in it. So now we can run it and see if we get that error. Okay, so my web scraper file creates a JSON file, and it did it with no error. And that's how you know it worked. We received no error this time, and now it's fixed. So I hope that helped you. Please leave a comment if it helped you, and thanks for watching. Goodbye, world.